15th chapter of the Gospel according to St. Luke. We have a Bible before you. Not there should be some in the pew. Gospel according to St. Luke. 15th chapter.
Destroy him.
They wanted to block his message, but the publicans and sinners wanted to hear his message. Why are you focusing on that, Reverend? And why did you say it so many times? Well, Brother Guerrero, for a good reason. Those of us who know we are in trouble, we want to hear the word of God. I wish I had a witness here. We don't care how many times we hear it. We don't care how many times it's preached. Those of us who are in trouble and who know that we're in trouble, we want to hear the word of God. The other side, the Pharisees and scribes, they felt like they did not need to hear the word because they felt like they were the word or were above the word. So therefore, they're trying to stop the word from going out to those who need it. Somebody missed that. They think that they don't need it, but they're now trying to stop the word from going out to those who do need it. But they all drew near, and because Jesus knew the makeup of the crowd that was listening, he tailor-made his message to those who were listening. Let's talk about the last one, and then I'm going to get to the middle. That last one about that son that left home, that spent all of his living on righteous living and took from his father and went into a far land. This is another sermon. I'm going to try to preach it. Just bring me up to date. When that boy came back home, they all rejoiced except for one somebody. And that was his own brother. Somebody said, well, what does that mean? See, the Pharisees, he meant for the scribes and Pharisees to hear that. He was letting them know that these publicans and sinners that wanted to hear this word, they were your brothers. And if you're already in the faith, you ought to want somebody else to come and be in the faith with you. I wish I could preach this. But that boy that was at home kept telling his dad, why are you making a big to-do over this boy who went and spent all of your money, didn't want anything to do with us, and here I take on that same nature, and we need to be careful about it. That when people join the church, we want to make them not like Jesus, but we want to make them like us. Everybody can't be like us. And I thank God that some folk that God bring ain't like me, because I can't deal with me sometimes. And we need to be trying to create disciples rather than church members. A good disciple will make a good church member. But a whole lot of folk that know church don't know Christ. That is not his name. Yeah, there are some folks that's listening to us today live. They're not at church, Milton. But there's enough church in them that they tune in and want to hear the word of God. They may not be able to come and sit in the pew. They may not have the luxury of that lady or someone to bring them. But they're listening this morning because they believe that even in their bed, or even sitting beside the bed, or even in the hospital room, there's going to be something that comes in there that's going to give them a reason to pray. And here we are sitting in here with all of the luxuries that we ought to be because we're Christians. And we can't even get an amen. And I said, God, something is wrong with somebody. The first parable. George ain't going to these folks again. Same folk. Pharisees and scribes. He said, a certain man had 100 sheep. And one of them went straight. Got lost. in the wilderness and said, now what man of you that have a 100 sheep would not leave the 99 and go get the one? And I said, oh, that's a hard thing to do. Because first of all, if you're a fault finder, you're going to say to yourself, he left his responsibility. Yeah, if you're a fault finder, you can always find something wrong.
Yeah, he should have stayed there, just let that little go.
You got 99, and that's the most majority. See, that's the way we count. In fact, that's the way we give. When we say, I got $100, they want me to give one? No, I ain't gonna do that, because then I ain't gonna have the 99. Somebody help me here. And let alone the Lord ask for $10, that's the time. Oh, no, I ain't gonna have the 99. Y'all don't have anything. Somebody help me here. And if we don't attach to quality, we look at value as being quantity instead of quality. But he's saying, 99, okay, he's shirking his responsibility. He's supposed to be with the 99. But there's a higher calling that some folks don't understand. He says, that man, when he goes after the one which is lost, when he finds him, are you praying with me? He lays the sheep on his shoulder. And when he cometh home, he called his neighbors and said,
complete my set.
And notice that when she lost it, she didn't blame the devil for taking it. Oh, I wish I could preach this morning. Too many of us always want to talk about what the devil has done. And I believe we give the devil way too much credit. That woman then said, the devil came in and stole my silver. She said,
yeah.
then the third thing is, and seek diligently. Y'all got the Bible open? Y'all got a couple more minutes, I've got 20. It says, seek diligently. You know what that means? Didn't give up, dear.
Right.
Didn't give up. Didn't give up. Can I some of us give up too quickly. You give up on people too quickly. Yes, the man that left the sheep, he went and looked for the one that was lost. The boy that left the house, his daddy was waiting on him when he came back. Somebody help me. This woman didn't give up looking for what she wanted. Somebody help me.
Thank you.
But if you think you lost something, don't go looking for it. Don't look for Jesus. Light it up. Sweep it. Don't give up. Ain't all right. Must first believe that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek. Don't you give up.